got apples and pecans and
I don't know, whatever other stuff you put in there.
Calories.
Yeah. But it's fruit, so it's healthy. Right, Al? It's got fruit in it, it doesn't count.
That's right.
Hi, John.
Hey,
two items on here. Yeah, full house.
All right, should we get started?
Yes, we should.
All right, we'll call this meeting to order, the September 26th, 2016 CPDC meeting. Good evening, everybody. All right, we're going to take things out of order a little bit. We're going to start with the Mariano Drive reduction of the surety amount. So, Jean, anything you want
to? So what you have in your packet is the bond release request for Mariano Drive. This is a subdivision. The original bond amount was $262,579.90, and that was from December 8th of 2014. And then you can see what the work has been accomplished. And the recommendation is to release $191,879.90 of the current bond being held and establish a new bond amount of $70,700. And then there's an estimate of what that would be used for. Excuse me. Lots of, retaining wall, island landscape, on and on and on, sidewalk, roadway, granite curb, trees, loam seed.
As built.
Do we usually get something from the town engineer recommending this?
Sometimes we do. I think this one's pretty straightforward.
I think Ryan said something. I thought Julie had something from Ryan because originally it was 69 and then Ryan adjusted it to 70.
Okay.
Okay. Right, there's the 10% contingency, whatever, that he added in. Right.
Okay, so we're covered from that angle?
Yep.
Okay. Any comments or questions from the board?
I reviewed it online, looked perfectly reasonable.
Okay. Karen, anything? All right. Have a motion?
Oh, let me see what the motion should say. Okay. So move that the CPDC accept the recommended modification to the bond release for the definitive subdivision plan for Mariano Drive in Reading, Mass. And establish a new bond amount of
$70,724.50.
Or actually, it was the recommended is $7,700.
Yeah.
Okay. All those in favor?
Thanks.
Thanks,
Sam.
Bumping me up too, appreciate it.
Yeah, sure.
No problem.
Gene, do I need to sign this? It says sign here.
Yes.
Sure.
Director of Community Development, whatever.
I think Jeff's, John Hancock was.
Okay.
Okay. Is that the only spot?
I think so.
Yeah, all of us signed the original one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's right. All right. Okay. Excellent.
Sure.
All right, so next up on the agenda public hearing for the storage trailer special permit at Wingate Healthcare, 1364 Main Street. And I think there is a public notice here.
I have one if you need it.
So if Nick wouldn't mind reading that.
Notice is hereby given under section 4.4 and 5.5.1I of the Reading Zoning Bylaw. Community Planning and Development Commission will hold a public hearing on Monday, September 26, 2016 at 7:30 p.m. in the Selectmen's Meeting Room at Reading Town Hall, 16 Lowell Street, to hear the request for a special permit for an accessory storage trailer at 1364 Main Street, Assessor's Map 51, Lot 146, by Wingate Healthcare. A copy of the application and associated plans are available to the public in the Community Services Department in Town Hall, Monday through Thursday from 7:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. and Tuesdays from 7:30 a.m. to 7 p.m.
All right, great. So we'll handle this as follows. And I'm sorry, sir, are you here for
yes.
this one?
I'm representing Wingate.
Okay, great. Thank you. So we'll have Gene just give a brief overview. Ask you to add your perspective to it. We'll debate and discuss it. It doesn't look like, unless you're here for the public comments period of this, doesn't look like we've got much public debate in this one. But we'll open it up and then close the public hearing and vote on it. So pretty straightforward. So Gene, you want to start
sure.
us out?
This was something that came to our attention, and I guess it's just being used for basic storage of materials. And so we wanted to bring it before the board and have it go through the process of getting this, you know, being subject to the special permit. Conservation has looked at this and they have no issue with it. So I think it's pretty straightforward.
Okay. So you wanna
get
some into it?
The building itself is really tight on storage, and obviously we do a lot of short-term rehab. We have a lot of electric beds, walkers, wheelchairs that eventually get donated to the facility. We just don't have the room within the facility. So we're looking at some accessory storage. We already have two sheds on site. And because of the wetlands, we really do not have any available space outside the wetlands other than the location shown on the site plan. Where that location is, we are encroaching on the side yard setback. So we did get a letter of support from the abutter. They have no objection with it. So that's pretty much what it is. And it's, you know, it's a simple storage container. It could be loaded up on a flatbed and moved. All the deliveries to the storage show will come actually from the building. There'll be no vehicle deliveries to it. So it's pretty benign, no power.
This is it here, right?
Yes, that's it. Right.
Where is it?
It's right here.
Right there, just outside the fire lane.
Oh yeah, okay.
Right on the front.
You really can't even see it. I went down to look at it today and had to go a couple painted, times to try and find it.
Yeah, it's painted green, so it blends
it
in.
It really does.
So this is already in place, it's there right now.
Yeah, so what had happened was the administrator went to conservation. Conservation had no issue with it, and she thought that was all the permitting that she needed. And they actually put it in place. And I got a phone call that said, you know, you have a storage container on here? I was like, no. They went ahead and did it. So, you know, we reached out. We met with Julie and she said, well, let's go through the process. So that's why we're here tonight.
I gotcha.
make it legal.
Perfect. Thank you.
So, I don't know if we actually have the authority to approve it the way that it is located now and that you show it, because under the, I think this is the right version, from November 2015, we have the authority to grant a special permit for a steel storage unit, all right, but provided that such accessory structures meet all yard requirements. So if it doesn't meet, if where you put it doesn't meet the yard requirements, I think that ends up being a variance.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think that we have the authority to approve it.
I understand.
The, I mean, I was, had the same impression that John did. The, but I was also curious, I mean, it, from the photos, it looks like it's accessed end on.
No, it's in the wrong location where it is today.
Okay.
So rather than just picking it up and moving it multiple times,
mm-hmm.
figured we'll just leave it where it is. It's not bothering anybody. The abutters are okay with it. If we got the approval, we'll get it and we'll put it as located on the map.
Okay.
If it's not approved, we're just going to get rid of it. Because there is no other site, there is no other location on that property where we can locate that trailer.
Well, I was, one of the things I was actually curious about was how often and under what circumstances it is accessed. Those, when you put things in or take things out and put them to use and so forth.
It's accessed fairly regularly. So we have 123 electric beds in the facility, mm-hmm. but sometimes we have patients that come in that need specialty beds, whether it's a bariatric bed or what have you. We can't store the bed, the existing bed, inside the facility because of DPH regulations and life safety requirements. So we need to take the bed physically out of the building.
Mm-hmm.
So that happens fairly regularly. And then with the acute rehab, they're constantly changing wheelchairs and walkers and stuff like that. So that trailer will be accessed fairly regularly. We used to have a storage, a rental storage place, someplace in town. I don't know exactly where mm-hmm. it is, but that was really a pain because the maintenance guy would have to get in his truck, drive down, get what they needed, and then bring it back. This way, the rehab staff or nursing can go and get the beds and or the equipment.
Okay. I mean, because nowadays there are things like the PODS service, the portable on-demand storage, where they will just bring it to you when you need it and leave it there for, I mean, of course it's an expense, but it's something which is within the zoning permissions, if you will.
Right. The other problem with that site is parking is at a premium. So we can't afford to lose any parking spots. So if they came and they dropped a pod, where would they drop the pod? Can't drop it in the fire lane. So.
Okay.
Why don't we think about it for a few months?
Yeah.
It would be okay with the new bylaw.
Where is the trailer now?
The trailer is in the location shown on the site plan. However, it's perpendicular to the fire lane. Actually, encroaches our neighbor's property.
So it's on. It crosses the property line.
Yeah,
is what you're saying?
The
yeah.
Postponed indefinitely. Pick it up at another time.
Yeah, that's probably the right way to proceed.
The issue we have, under the current zoning bylaw, we cannot approve it.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot offer the special permit, but there is zoning changes in process that would give us an opportunity, I believe.
So
yeah, so
yeah, so instead of rejecting it because
right.
we don't have anything it sort of makes more sense to see whether the proposed changes get approved by town meeting, and then it just doesn't seem, I'm going to use the term ripe right now, and there's this other procedural thing that's
so how does the board want me to handle the container right now? Is it okay to leave it while we're still waiting? Do I have to remove it? I mean, that's really ultimately the question.
How are we handling the violation notices and so forth.
Well, I think this is a unique situation because the bylaw is changing and would, you know, we'll never be sure if it's going to get passed, but if it does get passed, that I think sets the stage for this to be considered, reconsidered.
Right.
So in situations like that where the rules are really in the midst of being changed, it's awfully hard for us to take a position of enforcement. It's a little unfair.
We've had, I'm going to say, enforcement actions that have gone much longer, you know, that have taken a much longer time frame to
We look at enforcement, if someone's trying to work through the process, then we acknowledge that there's the effort being made. I guess where we would maybe pursue enforcement is where we don't feel like we have a working relationship. But I think in this situation, you can see the applicant is trying to correct this and do the right thing. So
yeah,
don't see any problem with enforcement.
Be on good terms with your neighbor.
Yeah, it's not causing a problem for anybody, right?
No, fortunately, our sister company actually manages that property, so it's
it's not an issue.
And it's not, you can't even see it from the street.
So keep it where it is. We'll get through November. We'll get through the Attorney General's review. They have to review and approve everything. Then I think we'll check back in with you once that all gets through, which would probably be about February at the latest.
If you want to contact Julie after the first of the year.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll send Julie a note. I'm sure she'll read the meeting minutes anyway.
So I think that'll get us through and we should end up in a good spot.
Okay. Yep.
The town meeting.
Move that the CPDC continue the public hearing for the special permit request for Wingate Healthcare until, how do I specify a date?
Meeting in February?
First quarter.
Meeting in February?
I would say sometime after the first of the year. I don't know if you have to be specific.
Okay. Until February 2017.
All those in favor?
Okay.
All
right.
Okay.
All right.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Moving quickly along.
I know.
All right, so next up on the agenda is the signed permit. It's a blade sign permit for Professor's Market at 505 Main Street. And Frank, I think you're here. Great, thanks for coming. Gene, anything you want to do to open this up?
I think this, another one's pretty straightforward. We're looking at a blade sign and this is a relatively new business in town, just trying to get a little more exposure.
Excellent. Frank, any comments you want to make on this application?
No, we did it. We specifically designed it like this to be within the guidelines, so just looking to maybe get people to glance over twice.
Sure.
Way to work or from work, so.
Yeah.
Good.
I think it looks nice.
So, which block here?
It's the old Quiznos.
Oh, okay. I like the sign.
Yeah. Yeah, the wall sign came out nice.
Yeah, it really did. And there's no illumination that goes with this. It's just a straight blade sign. Right?
Yep.
How late are you open until?
8.
And I remember early on when you first came in, had some discussion about the awning.
Yeah.
We're not talking about that in here, right? Okay.
No, I actually got some shades inside to take care of that problem.
Oh, okay.
The sun was just really hot. So
yeah.
Just found a different solution.
Good. Okay. Any questions on this?
No, pretty straightforward.
Okay. Move that the CPDC approve the certificate of appropriateness for the proposed blade sign at 505 Main Street, Professor's Market.
All those in favor?
You're good.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
We need to.
Do I need to stamp this?
That's not a bad idea.
Stamp out?
I got the stamp.
There you go.
Sure.
Thanks.
Go to it.
Oh, yeah.
That's
thank
it.
You guys. Take
thanks.
Care.
All right. Thanks, Frank.
All right. Thanks. Oh, yeah. Thanks. Okay.
Stamp on the loose.
Next up. Oh, wow. That is just cranked through a lot. Discussion and vote on CPDC positions, chair, vice chair, I guess secretary. Those are the three positions, correct?
It's chair and secretary.
Is it just chair and secretary?
Yeah.
Okay.
We didn't do this in July?
Nope, short cord.
Yeah, we tried to, but...
Yeah.
Clever.
That was a year before I was thinking of.
Well, in the normal tradition of things, I nominate Nick Safina for chair of the board, ongoing.
I, from my perspective, I'd like to step down. So I'm happy to hand it over to whomever. Nick, I think, would be a fine candidate if he's willing and able. He's certainly able if he's willing.
I'm insane enough, yeah. Yeah, I think if you're ready.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, it's been 2 years. It was, I've been through.
2 years. I did that too, I think. Did you do that too? I know I did a 2 year, and that's
yeah,
enough.
So.
That's, you're done.
Yeah. It's a lot of fun, but
yeah.
It was good. I learned a lot, so it was good, but definitely ready to hand it off. All right.
We've forgotten how to do this.
Yeah. We need a second on the
I'll second that.
All those in favor?
All right.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
Then vice chair?
Secretary?
Or secretary, yeah.
Who's ready?
John?
Really, what you're doing is priming yourself up to be chair the next year.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I mean, I that wouldn't be the worst thing in the world for me to do.
Nominate John Weston.
Second.
Second.
All those in favor? All right.
There you go.
Yeah.
Excellent. So do we switch, like, is that official immediately?
I think we'll probably wait till the next meeting.
Okay, that's cool. It's fine.
To run.
I know, like, can I get out of here now?
There's cake. There's a game tonight.
Yes, there's cake.
I know.
I have one thing if I
yeah,
could.
Please.
Some of you that came to the Board of Selectmen's meeting the other night heard some discussion about Article 19, and I brought some copies of the article. I'm not sure if this has gone around to everybody, but it was really in the last week or so that this Article 19 surfaced. It's a general bylaw article, and when we talked about it at the Board of Selectmen meeting, the discussion really was around the critical, this is a stormwater article, and it it was discussed that really CPD's input on this, and the Board of Selectmen made a point of saying they most definitely want to get CPDC's input, because it, as I say, it just more or less town council presented it and said, you know, you really need to be in compliance, and this, that's what this new language would do, would make you in compliance. So so this is what you have before you, which is the stormwater management and erosion control and an overall stormwater bylaw that is now going to be consistent with the latest and greatest of what's required. We have until next year around this time to come into compliance, but the Board of Selectmen felt like it was, you know, something that just kind of popped up from town council and wanted CPDC to have some input and make a recommendation. If this is better suited, if it needs more time to come back to annual town meeting, the Board of Selectmen was saying that that would certainly wouldn't be a problem, and town council was there, you know, advising and said as long as it gets at least to the annual town meeting, that would be time enough to meet that deadline of next September, I believe it is.
Okay, I was at the meeting, but I don't remember offhand. We need to tie the zoning to the new bylaw at some point, because one of the consequences of this is that we'll adjust criteria or zoning requirements to require compliance with, or at least mention compliance with this.
I guess playing on that, I'm not sure we need to tie the two, but what I guess, because if you can have lots of different requirements for a site, they don't necessarily all have to have, they don't need to necessarily reference each other. Mm. But the way that I just glanced through this, that we'll have I would presume that we would take this up at the same time as a zoning site plan approval. We have this erosion and sediment control plan, shall include a site plan, da da da. And so, are we going to then have two separate actions for each site plan? One as a enforcer of the
general
bylaw, and one as our regular oversight activities. Mm.
Why,
I guess that's a
well, in the interest of efficiency, we want to avoid duplication. But my understanding from the discussion at the Board of Selectmen is this is basically preventing or preempting any loophole that might exist between state regulations and zoning and so forth. So basically this says whenever you do something that impacts, that might impact the stormwater effects on or off your property, you got to do something.
Why isn't this just like in our decisions when we reference the construction hours? Right. This is it's a finding that it's a material that would be submitted.
Mm-hmm.
There'd be a finding that it complies with, and or a condition that it comply with.
Right.
That bylaw. Why is it?
Yeah.
And it's part of our review, but why is it anything more than that?
I don't think it is anything more than that, except that it might lighten the load of things that are currently done in site plan. In other words, it's, instead of doing it in our own site plan review, this is the controlling regulation. And as you say, it's just a reference.
Well, I guess I would need to dig into it deeper, but
right.
I guess that's my concern, because in just looking at it, closely, I mean, quickly here, that it's, it is, CPDC is...
the enforcer.
Yes.
And they have to hold a public hearing.
Right. Mm-hmm. So there are rules specific to this. It's not like in a lot of things that we do, you just need to comply with these rules. Mm-hmm. That's it looks like that's different than the way mm-hmm. this is set up. This is, okay, there's a set of procedures that we need to follow within this bylaw.
Yep.
And whether we can wrap those in to be consistent or concurrent with site plan review under zoning, I would hope that we could be able to do that, but that's what I would want to make sure is that we don't end up with these weird duplicative processes that are just...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Some way so that we can get as close as possible to just referencing, you know, that. And I'm not sure that the way that it's written here, just a quick glance, leads itself to that.
Well, they're saying that they want a site plan as part of this, stamped, certified by a professional engineer with certain, you know, all the information. So it would be nice to think that as part of a regular site plan review, it would just be one more piece. Sure.
Right. Could it be the same? Could it? Are the kind of the questions
you're
I think.
You're questioning whether our public hearing for a site plan review has to be separate from a public hearing for this review?
I wasn't thinking about even that far, but yeah, I think we need to, when we review this. I guess that's where I'm. When we review this, we need to think about these two processes work together.
So in 7953, the language says that the hearing may be combined with the hearing for any other permit or approval from the same project under the jurisdiction of CPDC.
Right.
I think it's drafted with that spirit. It's just a question of is there enough? Do we need more time to really digest this and how it's going to work? And
I mean, would we ever have a hearing like this outside of a site plan review?
Seems like yes. Because our site plan review,
even allow for that?
Well,
I don't even know.
We have minor site plan review, and
somebody might revise a stormwater management plan or come up with one for an existing site.
Okay.
This, one of the ways that this would come into play would be another trigger requiring site plan review.
Yeah.
We just wrote it.
Yeah,
we did.
Yeah, I don't want to assume that the only way to handle this is a brand new section to our general bylaw. If there's a way we can weave it into site plan review or...
Well, I think the point is that you don't want it wrapped into zoning, right?
Right.
That's the...
Yeah.
It wants to sit in the general bylaw. But then the question is, how do you... Combine
the two. I guess the thing that jumped out at me was, I forget who mentioned it first, but is if we have a decision, if we have a decision on a site plan review, can we wrap conditions related to this into, you know, right into there, or do we need to start to pull those two things out separately? So it will be a site plan decision and a stormwater plan review, and we have two separate parts. That's the kind of thing that I was just thinking of as I was looking through this.
Yeah,
I would hope that we could.
Sure.
Yeah. Well, I think that was the our town council basically says that we have to have this as a general bylaw. We're getting push, I guess, from the state.
Mm-hmm.
But the, you know, how to minimize the governmental cost, if you will, is up to us.
Procedurally.
You know, yeah, procedurally.
Yeah.
I think it fits right in, actually.
The selectmen's meeting was the public hearing for this?
For closing the warrant.
Yeah, it was just to close the warrant. It really wasn't a public hearing.
Did anybody show up? I couldn't make it.
Oh, yeah, the three of us were there.
Yeah, I mean, we have saw a lot of actually what looked like environmental engineers in town meeting, for example, that always respond to this kind of stuff. I'm just wondering if we got any reaction from people in the know.
Not in that meeting.
I mean, this is beyond my level of comfort for understanding how it complies.
So I think this required a lot of other documentation that we normally don't see in typical site plan. I think it was John Halsey that raised the question of the cost of some of this stuff. But anyone developing a parcel or purchasing a parcel, particularly of commercial real estate, will already have this done for a million other reasons.
Right.
So the cost, I think, is already negligible to whoever's bringing this in front of us. Because this document, or multiple of these documents, are already going to be produced for lending, for purchasing, for, you know, clearing environmental before you purchase the parcel. A lot of this is already going to be done.
Yeah.
But if you've never looked at one of these, you're going to start ripping your hair. There's just 300 pages of, oh my God.
Well, and that's what we're going to be looking at with town meeting, where we're already putting so much in front of them. This is going to...
I mean, I have samples of these I can bring to you guys. I'm just going to...
Whether you write this or not, they're required to comply with this for this under the state law.
Right.
Sure.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
So is the I guess is the immediate question, do we push this to April?
Yeah, that's the Board of Selectmen, they were looking for feedback because it's going to sit with CPDC.
Kind of stinks too, because we got other stuff we wanted to queue up for April.
Well, I thought this was that was included in the warrant.
It is. It is in the warrant.
Yeah, yeah.
It's in the warrant. I mean, it can certainly go if if you know.
Well,
it's
which,
in there.
Yeah, but that means that this is it for us. It's for information only until it gets passed by town meeting, and when it does get passed by town meeting, then we have to accommodate it.
So is this our opportunity? I mean, I'm with Nick. I would just let this keep going unless when we review this, we see something in here that's just gonna...
Yeah, I look...
Just gonna be...
I looked through it, you know, as you did. I mean, there's a lot of stuff, but there's nothing catastrophic. I mean, there's nothing a blocker, as far as I could see.
What's your reasoning for letting it go?
I don't think it's going to get any more developed, and I think the only hitch right now is us trying to understand how to enforce it, review it.
Yeah, my guess in just looking through here, the details of it's not going to change. Mm. We're not going to even be able to change it that much, right? I mean, it's most of this, like you say, I mean, most of this is stuff that they're required to do anyways. It's just pulling it out so that we have a little bit, we have something that controls it as well.
Yeah, I mean, it says right here, the failure of CPDC to essentially adopt rules does not, in effect, suspend or invalidate the requirements of the section. They're required to comply with it, whether we tell them, whether we check them or not.
Right.
Yeah. So if we, are we expected to vote in favor of or not in favor of?
No, I think it's, as it is right now, it's on the warrant. But I think as a courtesy, the Board of Selectmen just felt like they wanted to make sure CPDC was okay just with it as
it is.
Or if it needed more time or, you know.
Is somebody going to say, at town meeting, did CPDC vote to recommend? Do we need to do that?
Well, I'm sure what could come up at town meeting is, you know, we want to hear from CPDC since they're going to be the ones administering this. And
Okay.
When is the latest we can vote on it?
It's already been approved by included in the warrant, so there's really no need for a vote. I guess it's just a general, is there a consensus on the board that everybody's okay with this proceeding as it is, or should we, you know, give this some more thought and more time?
When you say it's on the warrant, meaning this language,
that's
or
it. The board voted it.
Yes.
So you can amend stuff.
Oh, that's...
Well, that's why there was no... That's why I asked if there was a hearing.
It's a general bylaw. I mean,
basically, all it really says is that we can adopt and or periodically amend rules, right, to effectuate the purposes. Nice, that's lawyerese there. And that's it, really. There's no other rules. There's nothing else in here about how we implement this. Effectuate
it. As best I could interpret the whole thing, what it... It's whether or not a development project requires a site plan review for any other reason, it requires this under certain conditions. Mm-hmm. So it's basically, it's an anti-loophole thing, and it's in the general bylaw to give it some weight. You know, because in cases where in the past where it has been clearly an issue of, you know, disturbing lots of things and water flow and drainage and whatever, we go over this stuff anyway. But this says that regardless of zoning, regardless of the size of the mm-hmm. project, if you meet this particular set of criteria, you've got to comply.
So can I ask that we take this up during our next meeting, just to give us a chance to review it, mm-hmm. and then I guess if there is a set of edits that we collectively feel like we should make, then we can suggest that, and that would be our report or our, you know, our input into it at town meeting, right? I mean, that's the way that they've set it up for us.
Yeah, I mean, any member
right.
could propose an
yeah,
amendment.
Yes.
But,
I mean, I wouldn't suggest that we do that, just tweaks to make tweaks.
Right.
But if there's something that we feel that's needs to be addressed before it gets approved.
Feedback.
Yeah.
We have another meeting before town meeting, so that's good.
Okay.
I think we should vote to recommend or not recommend. I feel like we're going to be asked of that.
It's a little bit different. Let me just make doubly sure, but it's a little bit different than the zoning, where under zoning, yes. This is article. The numbering is a little off on this, but under zoning, yes, CPDC has to needs to make a report, and that's under state law. The general bylaw
is the bylaw committee, basically.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they're looking
But they're looking for input.
Mm-hmm.
So the way it was explained to me is it okay to go now? Should it be pulled and reconsidered, you know, put back on the warrant in the spring? That type of thing. We didn't really get into whether or not, I mean, I'm sure feedback, if it could go now, would be helpful. But as it stands, this is the language for the warrant. But maybe if we put on the next agenda, we can have some more discussion.
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Chance to go through it in a little bit more detail.
Okay. Anything else, Jean?
The only other update I had to share was I did the preliminary site walk at Artis Senior Living. And I have to go back tomorrow. The property looks good. You know, they've got a little more landscaping to get in there. The fencing is all in.
You put the two-sided sign up with the fence extended along it.
Yeah.
So, I have driven that way several times at night. That light when you come on the 28 North is right in your eyes. Can
that's
we
I'm going to look at tomorrow.
Do something.
The light on the...
The light comes up on the side.
On the sign.
Oh, he's cut
it's
that.
It's straight in your eyes when you drive 28 North.
He's cut that light. He's not... He's got a lot of complaints about it, so he's not even turning that on.
Good.
They were on tonight.
It was on tonight?
Yes, when I was coming.
Well, I'm going tomorrow night with one of the building inspectors to look at just the lighting.
Okay.
Yeah, he told me that sign light was turned off.
Oh, it's brutal when you drive a little.
Maybe it's on timer. He doesn't pay attention.
Maybe.
To it.
No, it's good to know.
Tell him to light the other side.
Yeah.
Install the light on the other side.
Make him install halo lighting.
Yeah.
But it looks good as you're driving by it, whatever, 40 miles an hour, 30 miles an hour.
Yeah. It looked better in the renderings. The building's kind of...
Well, it looks better than Eric's.
Better than what was there.
Yeah.
Sure. it's an important building.
Yeah.
The fencing in the back, when I walked back in the courtyard area, I was a little surprised at the way they did the fencing. I want to take another look at that. Because there were, like, a couple of layers of fencing up on that retaining wall, that huge retaining wall that they built. It's kind of like double layers of fencing.
Hmm.
I wasn't quite sure what that was about.
Because the patients like to escape.
But because of that retaining wall, I think they got fouled up with the fencing, and it's... So needs some more observation.
Speaking of looking better than what was there, anything with Perfectos?
I don't know.
I think they go in and
one
screw something
piece
in and
of wood at a time.
Take off. Let's go in, put a light bulb in. See you next week.
Can't even pretend to know what's going on with that. The 40B down at the train station, that got continued last Thursday night. The applicant did not, they didn't give us the payment in sufficient time to get the peer review civil engineer on board in time to get him. He could do the report, but he couldn't make the meeting. So everything was so last minute that, and that was the whole point of having that meeting. So that's got continued to October. It's the 17th. And then we're expecting to hear on St. Agnes. They filed all their paperwork with the Mass Housing Partnership. We sent a letter with comments, so we expect a letter from MHP to be forthcoming any day now, approving a letter of eligibility. And then there's a fifth 40B that's in the queue. So.
Where's that one?
They're looking at a site on the periphery, way down, not too far from like the Home Depot area. On that side of Walker's Brook.
You have some inside knowledge there, or don't you?
Yes, that would be the corner of Lakeview and Eaton, after the apartment buildings, where Zanny used to be.
Where?
I'm sorry, Tony DeRosa, 130 John Street. where Zanny's construction company used to be.
Okay, I'm not sure.
If you go down Lakeview, go by the apartments.
Mm-hmm.
Just keep going down that, and you have to take a left to come up Eaton.
Okay.
That area, where they had the construction, the dirt piles they were storing for MWRA.
Place.
Okay.
Do we know anything about how large that one is?
They're still working out the plans, but it's in the queue. It's interesting because the ability to access all of that parking up at Jordan's Furniture would be, in a perfect world, just do a flyover or whatever.
Yeah.
And not have to worry so much about parking on the site. But it's
there's a little,
little
bit
tricky.
Of a great difference.
A little bit.
Differential.
Although it's not that bad. We actually walked it. It's actually not that bad when you go out and you look at it. There's one spot where it's I could envision a footbridge or whatever. But it gets complicated, so.
Because that's a site, basically, right? If you're standing up there on that, the top of that wall on the side of Jordan's,
mm-hmm.
as you
side.
Go up there.
Yep, that's where we were.
You basically are overlooking that site.
You are.
Yeah.
That's exactly what we did. We actually climbed up on that, you know, hung onto the fence and looked over and said, wow, it's right
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the engineering would be like on something like that.
Funicular.
Yeah.
Tony?
Tony DiRosso, 130 John Street. I have a question for the assistant town manager. Is there a limitation to the number of 40Bs that can be active at any given time?
Not that I'm aware of, no. I mean, we're subject to any and all until we hit that 10%.
And with the number of 40Bs that are going in, how close are we getting to that 10%?
We're over 200 short, so.
Well, remember, there's the two different thresholds. Is
yeah.
I guess Stoneham is the one who's working on the 1.5%.
Yeah, that's a pretty tough one.
Yeah.
Almost no one can make that. The difficulty is, as we improve, it's sort of a false positive, because when the decennial census is updated, then we get the full count of all the units. So the numerator and the denominator both get updated.
Right.
As it is right now, we're only getting credit for the affordables.
Oh, I thought when a 40B went in, we got credit for the entire project.
We do, but the way the inventory is maintained by the state,
mm-hmm.
they only update their inventory with just the affordable units. They don't update of all the housing units in the town.
So it's deceiving. So every 10 years when the decennial census comes in and we have the count for all of that growth over the town, we take a big giant step backwards.
Yep. We grow the numerator, but not the denominator until
so,
that 10
you know,
years.
So it keeps doing this. We think we're almost there,
yeah.
but then we get the new census information in, and we...
Do we know if it could work the other way, where we could actually have more 40Bs, and once they do the decennial, say, oh, wait, now you're all set. You've actually got too much.
What it really boils down to is if we had one large 40B...
Rental,
then that would probably carry us for the next 10 years.
And large would be how big?
14,000? I don't know the answer to that. We're looking in the crystal ball trying to figure out what that number is.
Well, for example, I mean, I think from a practical point of view, if the somehow or other the senior independent living at Redding Woods converted to eligible rental only, that would probably put us over. That's like 250 units, something like that. But I mean, if it's an ownership thing, we only get credit for the 20% or whatever it is that are affordable and protected. If it's rented, if it's rental, like the I guess the St. Agnes is intended to be.
Yeah, all the 40Bs that we're looking at are all rental.
Then we get credit for all the units, whether or not they're the affordable ones.
What's
three out of five are rental.
Prescott Lincoln one.
Prescott Lincoln is rental. St. Agnes is rental.
How many units are they looking at now, targeting?
72.
St.
Agnes
is
24, 20.
I thought they dropped it to 20.
20.
Yeah.
20.
That's only two of the five.
And then the Lakeview Ave is, I don't know, maybe it's 100.
And right.
In
one building? We don't know anything about it.
I don't, haven't seen a lot of detail. I'm just, that's a big site, so.
I mean, that's 200. That's close to 200, plus the potentially the one that came in with a subdivision.
There's that on Lyle Estates, but that would be home ownership. And then there's the old one that's Beacon Court, 45 Beacon, which I believe is also home ownership townhouses. This one goes way back. So that's the five.
That's 200 units, or a little over 200 units. I don't know what's expiring.
Yeah, the Housing Authority has had a few expire that they don't want to put new agreements to.
I thought, what, at one time, was there something where you got a 1 year?
Yes.
Hiatus.
Yes, you can get
hiatus.
Certified.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it's like, you have to hit, you have to have a creation of 0.5%.
Yeah. A progress bonus, if you will.
Yes.
Half a percent.
And then you get a year. A year off.
What's that, 0.5% on the 8,000?
Mm-hmm. I think we said in the housing plan it's got to be like, I'm not going to remember the number.
42 something?
Something like 50 units.
Yeah.
But
okay,
the way DHCD counts it, like it has to be within a certain calendar year, and a certain building permit has to be pulled, and there's all these rules around it, the timing of it.
Hmm.
And so much, it has to be built within so much time or you lose it. There's all these moving parts to it that, as I say, the one large one and we could be done, like one and done.
But either Lakeview or the Depot one should buy us that.
Depot won't.
Because you think it's going to take longer to finish that, to put it online? They're not gonna mess around with that. They're gonna get that up fast.
Right.
It depends when it hits, really.
But at some point, it's going to hit, and from that point on, that's when we should go count them.
Well, if they all hit in the same year, then we'll probably get it regardless.
Yeah.
There'll overlap. There'll be some overlap between these.
Yeah.
So there should be more than 40 units.
I mean,
coming online at any time.
The Reading Village, you know, there's still a lot of questions on that one. I don't know when that's going to be.
Hmm.
Right now, I think it's December 15th, but people come to the meetings and ask a lot of questions. So.
Not surprisingly.
Yeah. I mean, who knows? Maybe the St. Agnes, if there isn't a lot of concern by the neighbors, maybe that one is easier to get done.
Mm.
I don't know. But it's tricky.
All right. Anything else, Jean?
That's it for me.
Want to knock out these minutes?
Sure.
All right. Start with the 8th of August. I reviewed these and I didn't see anything.
I didn't see anything either. Of course, I wasn't there.
I Karen, you good? All right.
Somebody else should probably make the motion.
Move that the CPDC approve the meeting minutes for August 8th, 2016.
Second.
All those in favor? Abstain? 3-0-2. All right, and then the 8th, or I'm sorry, the 22nd, I wasn't at this meeting, but I did review them. I thought they looked fine.
Any concerns?
Good.
Move that the CPDC approve the minutes of the meeting for August 22nd, 2016.
Second. Good, John. And a second?
Yep.
All those in favor? I can't.
Well, you can.
Yeah, that's right. I keep forgetting protocols.
So that's 401?
850. That's fine. Anything else? No? Move to adjourn?
Second.
All those in favor?
All right. And there's cake there to honor.